Oh, there y'all, sweetie. Mr. Hill's expecting you. Just walk right in. What's the matter, sugar? Can't got your tongue? Just get your honey in there.
Jasper.
It's Joe, sir.
Of course, Joseph. How long is it that you've been with this company, Joseph?
About 2 years, sir.
Ah, yes. Then by now you must know that what we do here is very important. National security may be just a word to most people, Jasper, but for men like you and I, it means so much more. We see the people behind those words. We understand that it means the safety of every citizen in this country, not to mention the shareholders, the hard-working clerks and stakeholders at the government funding agencies. It also means a lot of pressure. A lot. And some men just buckle. Which brings me to the main point of my agenda. The position just opened up, and we're promoting you, Jasper.
Sir?
Don't think the company doesn't notice its hard-working employees. We reward achievement in this organization, young man. And you've just made yourself a gold star. This means that from now on, you will be in charge of not only yours, but Frank's assignments, too. That's right. That means downstairs lab sanitation, drain assignments, the works. With all the clearance that entails, that's a lot of responsibility we're investing in you, Jasper.
I thank you, sir. But what about Frank?
I know you made a great team. Frank decided to pursue a different career path this morning. We wish him all the best. Oh, and of course you understand that we won't be able to present you with a fancy title or a miserable pay raise. This is a modern company, you understand. We like to keep a flat organizational structure here. So congratulations, Jasper. I bet you must be very excited to get back to work with all your new responsibilities.
Miss Goulet? Something's bad. The downstairs handkerchief has basement all over the blood. No, I mean...
Good heavens, sugar! That rag's got blood all over! Have you hurt yourself again?
No, it's...
You may look like capable grown men in those boiler suits,
but I'm not the one who...
No need to explain. Let me just take care of that for you. Now, let's see what Gloria has for you here. Ooh, nice clean band-aid. Just go wash...
But...
Now run along, you little scamp. Thank you.
out.
Mister, are you all right?
No! Don't!
I'm not sure what...
I asked you a question.
Yes, yes, I...
Good enough.
Should I be...
Shut! I know these things are...
Mister...
Quiet, and I'll be... Thankfully.
What is this?
It is a portable, interdimensional, planar membrane chronosync instrument. It's a goddamn time machine, okay? For reasons, you'll quickly come...
Mister, between the blood and...
Just take the damn device and...
Mister? Mister?
Help! Help! I need help in here!
Stay right there, sir.
Listen, you gotta help me. There's a guy in there. There's a lot of blood. He needs help.
I said, stay right there.
But I work here.
Keep your hands where I can see them. Palms flat against the wall. The police are on their way.
I don't want to be unreasonable here. All I want is some simple answers to some simple questions. Do you want this to become complicated, do you? Because, we can do that.
No, sir.
Yeah, didn't think so. Let's, see, I'm a simple, easygoing fella. I try to be affable and not go too hard on people. That's what I find works now, my partner over here. He's a different kind of guy. A real stickler for the rules. Ain't that right, Burke? See, I'm not too good with long, complicated answers. I confuse easily. So sometimes I gotta consult him, you know, in complicated matters. He's got a real talent for helping suspects. Simple. Thing is, he's not much of a people person, so most people seem to prefer dealing with me. So now, do you mind telling me what this is? Take your time.
Thank you.
far out. Wow.
crud.
Nice.
man. Damn. Damn.
place.
So normal. Same moon, same night sky. After an hour of driving, it's easy to forget all about that dead world back there. How could Lambert have survived, though? If he came from the future, how did he not die along with everybody else? I just saw his body in the morgue. Now I'm driving out to talk to him alive. How does that work? Do you just leave a copy of yourself every time you use the box? Is that it? Are there copies of me all over the place now?